Hello everybody, my name is Veronica Rieck and I'm currently working in Tübingen. And in this video, I want to explain you what my research is mainly about. In my research, I am focusing on characterizing the subsurface. And there is one parameter that I'm most interested in, which is the hydraulic conductivity. For doing so, I'm actually using salt tracer tests. And this has been done before, but I just frankly want to explain the concept. And it is to inject a tracer with color or a salt to one borehole, and then you have several other observation holes where you can actually record when this tracer is arriving in terms of time and place. And this has been done before, but you can actually do it a little bit more sophisticatedly, and that means you can inject the tracer in several depths and do the same experiment repeatedly. What is the problem about this, or what is the challenge? It's that this is fine for a homogeneous subsurface, because then the tracer will behave like a plume, and it's more like a diffusive plume, and so we can actually extend our knowledge from these observation boreholes a little bit further. But most of the times the subsurface is not homogeneous, but rather very heterogeneous, so you have some high conductivity zones, some low conductivity zones, and these are right next to each other. And this is actually dangerous. So I want to know it better than this. And the problem is that probably one of my boreholes doesn't hit a tracer because this highway, this high conductivity zone, is right next to each other, and that's where the tracer is passing. So I want to extend the previous setup with a geophysical method called ERT to have at least some sensitivity in between the boreholes. And for doing so, I've installed several electrodes in the boreholes, and I can actually do a time-lapse ERT in between. So this is the general concept, but you might ask you the question is, why is this even important? Why do I care? I mean, characterizing the subsurface sounds nice, but why do I actually care? And just imagine that you're about to build a gas station or a factory or something, and there is the risk of spilling a pollutant. And so you want to know, if that spill happens, how far does it reach in several days? And for that, for doing those, this modeling, you actually need the hydraulic conductivity in the subsurface. And by doing these tracer tests, you can actually characterize the subsurface before, do some studies and like risk assessment analysis without damaging the underground. And so this is one application, and I think it's a very important one, is for risk assessment for future factories or other engineering projects.